sufficient breathing? Can you put some oxygen on the baby?
Yep. Okay, let's put an IO in. We need to start bagging this baby. Are we getting good breath sounds for
us?
Can we get a second IO in or try for an IV? Let's get ready to intubate. Heart rate still very high.
How's the perfusion looking on this baby? This is the third bolus going in right now.
Let's give the baby some bicarb.
We have the glide scope, bag him up, suck that ND tube to a low continuous wall suction.
It's incredibly valuable to have a mannequin that's as lifelike as this to enable us to practice what it would be like in this in a code situation.
So you can build any type of scenario, you can make it go in any direction, and they can be changing the vital signs as you provide care, and we can have it go positive way that they're improving, or maybe the child is declining a little bit and they need to think about a new pathway to be going.
So I was able to manipulate the settings so that the child had a low blood pressure, had a very high heart rate, wasn't breathing very well, all the things that a normal baby would do, and then required the team to intervene.
And they're fascinated at how lifelike the simulation baby is, that they could see that they have seizures, or they could see their respiratory status changing, improving, that their pupil size changes.
It's lifelike enough that people can get into the scenario and actually feel like they can check for pulses and was there a response, making it a truly educational experience.
It's a safe environment. Everybody works really well together as a team, so they feel comfortable asking the questions that they would not want to be asking in a real life situation.
They did great. They responded well, and in fact, a good code scenario is you're not actually doing CPR because you've done the right things. It adds an outlet for a different form of education, which we didn't have before.
We appreciate their donation very much. It's been phenomenal learning for the staff.